You have the pink cake.
You were right. Hi, Trixie.
Hi,
I hope she's not here.
See, right,
we were at the student union while we were taping the concert.
What are you talking about?
Oh, Felicia. Frisco didn't want to run into her.
Look, it'll be a while for the takeout. You guys want something while we're waiting?
Coffee would be great.
Okay.
Yeah, I could use a burger, maybe.
Maybe? You could eat a burger in your sleep.
Come on.
Trixie?
Outside of his room all day, and goes inside and comes outside.
I don't know. Never had to face something like that.
Well, maybe we should invite her out somewhere and, start socializing again.
I doubt if she'd go. Yes.
No.
Josh, how much longer is it going to take?
Trixie said she'd hurry, okay?
Look, Tanya's not particular, okay? Just get it together and she doesn't mind, whatever. Yeah.
Relax, will ya?
Well, it's very difficult to do here.
Hey, Felicia.
What?
Hey, you're on your break. Why don't you sit down and join us?
Yeah, come on. No, that's okay. I don't want to intrude.
No, you wouldn't be intruding.
That's okay, Josh. Frisco, your concert was great. You really had the student union coming apart.
Yeah. I think it was the best one yet. Felicia, did you see Frisco sing?
Yes, I did.
You did?
That's right.
Now, what song went over big?
Lady of My Heart.
Yeah, I've never heard you sing that better.
It was a request. I had to sing it.
Well, you could have fooled me.
What do you mean?
You sounded, real.
Yeah, well, don't let everything you hear fool you.
Sometimes performers really arrange requests, don't they?
Well, yeah, it happens, but not with our concerts. I think Lady of My Heart's a natural for you, It'll follow Frisco wherever he goes.
It's hot now. May not be after the next one, People change.
Yeah, not to mention performers.
Right. Can we just drop the whole thing about the concert, all right? It's over.
Yeah, well, despite... What about your feelings?
I said it's over, okay?
I still think it was good.
Oh,
Felicia.
Look what I'm doing. I'm so sorry. Look what I did. This is...
Okay.
Goodness. I'm so sorry. Okay.
You might as well sit down.
Here. What?
So you're here. You just might as well sit down now.
Look what I did.
It's okay.
Thank you.
So... How's life, everybody? Good, huh?
Surely you realize you're not dealing with an outsider.
Pardon me?
I mean, Robert is my husband.
Oh, there's no doubt about that, Holly.
Well, then there's no need for you to be secretive with me, is there?
No need at all.
Then why don't you tell me?
Tell you what?
Burt Ramsey, less than 2 minutes ago, I distinctly heard you on this very telephone say that there's a hot new lead to whoever it is who tried to kill Tony.
That's true.
Then tell me who it is.
Holly, you know that I can't do that. Now, why don't you just go home, and when Robert gets there, whatever he wants to tell you, that's his business.
Nice try, Bert. But forget it. Robert's going to come here first, and this is where I am going to be.
Then why don't you sit down and make yourself comfortable? Late.
Oh, I'm sorry. Were you talking to me?
Nothing important.
Oh.
I was just saying it's getting late.
Late for what?
Well, not for anything special, just late in the day.
Oh, I see.
When most people are heading for home?
Bert.
Yes?
Forget it.
Holly, you certainly don't make it easy for me.
Now, come on, Burt. When have I ever made trouble for you?
Well, I just wish you'd understand my position.
Oh, I understand your position perfectly. You and Robert are trying to collar whoever it is who's trying to kill Tony.
Oh, that's right.
Apparently, something is going on. Naturally, you can't talk about it, not even to me.
Thank heavens, you do understand.
Finally.
So something is going on. I was right.
Oh, Holly.
Excuse me.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, all right, well, tell the man at the airport to check the flight manifest. All flights going out of Port Charles. After that, have him question airport personnel, the cab drivers, anybody around there, see if they recognize the identification of the suspect, and then get back to me. Very good, thank you. Holly, I really think you should go home. This could be a very, very long night.
Do you think Robert would suggest I go home?
Oh, I'm sure he would.
Well, I don't think he would. Why don't we call him and ask?
Holly, wait a minute. Why don't you take my word? I know Robert. He wouldn't want you to hang around here.
Yes, but I know Robert, too, and I know he would want me here.
I don't think so, but I'll tell him that you were here when he checks in, okay? Better idea. Why don't you write him a sweet little note, and I'll give it to him when he comes in. Here's pen and pad.
You're very accommodating, Burt, but I really would rather tell him myself. Could you ring him for me?
Holly, I...
You do know where he is, don't you?
Robert and I are always in direct communication.
Meaning you do know?
I can't say.
Then you don't know.
I mean, I can't tell you where he is. I... Loose lips sink ships. What I'm trying to say is, Robert might not like it.
All right, now after you check our files, check with New York. He may have a record there. Hopefully, they may even have a mugshot.
Now, if New York does pick him up, do you want him held on an open charge?
Anything. Anything at all till we can build a case on him. Of course, I first have to place him at the hospital at the time of the incident.
How can you do that?
Preferably with a witness who can give a positive ID. You recall that when we were at the hospital, I said that I wasn't acting like or thinking like a WSB agent.
Yeah, right.
Right. So when I started to think that way, I decided to substitute the dummy for Tony on the stretcher.
Yeah, just after the power failure.
Right. The mob of patients came streaming into emergency, and shortly after that, we had the smoke. Now, none of that could have been a coincidence.
Including all the people who got suddenly ill?
Including them.
Well, then, couldn't Hines have been one of those people, I mean, that got ill? Or couldn't he have been pretending to be ill in order to get into the hospital?
Yeah, Robert, that would have worked.
Yeah. You're right. And I know who might have seen him, either Felicia or Frisco. They were patients at the emergency room at about that time. Try Kelly. See if Felicia's there.
All right, you want Frisco, too?
Yeah. Find him, too, if you can.
Could be, huh?
Maybe.
Yeah, hello. Oh, Felicia, I'm glad I got you there. This is Captain Ramsey Police Department. Mm. Oh, no. It's nothing like that.
Coffee.
No. No, it's just that Commissioner Scorpio would like to talk to you. Yes, that's right. He'd also like to talk to Frisco. Do you know where... Oh, he is. Oh, that's fine. Well, tell him to stay there, and the commissioner will be over to talk to both of you. Right. Thank you very much. Frisco's at the diner, too.
Good. Listen, Bert, check with New York, will you?
Yeah, I'll make that call from my office.
Good.
One thing that I haven't got straight yet is, what made you suspect Hines in the first place?
These. I got a glimpse of these boots when I was pushed up against the wall by that stretcher. Now, Donnelly confirmed that they belong to Hines.
You know, there's something about these boots that rings a bell with me, too.
Hmm?
Do you remember Mariah saying that whoever it was who tried to harm her and Laura at the Hacienda, he was wearing red boots?
You know, she did.
The same boots that Luke gave to Laura, made by the same bootmaker.
You're right, my dear. You are bloody well right, my smart little genius.
Hmm? Mm. Oh, who are you calling?
Mariah.
Do you think she'd be able to identify Hines?
Hopefully. If she can, and she can place Hines, it's gonna link in a whole lot of people.
Help, Tanya, the salad dressing is in a separate container.
Explain to her for me, Lee, that I'd have brought it myself, but Scorpio wants to talk to me.
What is that all about anyway, do you know?
I have no idea. Probably wants to throw me back in jail. I don't know.
Oh. Yeah, but wait, that still doesn't explain why he wants to see you too, Felicia.
I don't know why he wants to see me. He just called, but he didn't explain.
Well, whatever it is, good luck.
Yeah, and you know, if you get thrown in jail, I'll send you a file.
Josh. Bye-bye.
See you. Bye.
Listen, you two, why don't you let me take care of the customers you want to talk or something, huh?
What makes you think that we want to talk?
Oh, I don't know. I just thought
maybe... Hey, Trixie, do me a favor and don't jump to conclusions, all right?
All right. What's with Mr. Nice?
It's a long story, Trixie.
Hmm.
Sit over here.
Right, anywhere you like. I don't have... We'll be busy for about another half an hour or so.
Huh?
Don't you think we should all sit at one table? Frisco, why don't you join us?
Good idea. Mm-hmm. All right. I'll get straight to the point. As you know, I'm conducting an ongoing investigation into the attempt on your brother's life.
We know that with very few results.
The results aren't final yet. However, I do have a strong suspect. Before we go into that, I'd just like to mention that this is an official police investigation. As such, everything...
We already know that, Robert. Who?
This is precisely the sort of attitude that can't be tolerated. Now, I do have a suspect, yes. And I may or may not be able to prove that he's the person I'm looking for. That is, with your help.
You want us to help? No, I don't know anything about catching criminals.
No, but you do know who you saw and what you saw.
And if either of you saw the suspect...
Well, you still haven't told us what is this guy's name, Robert. That's all I want to know.
Matt Hines.
The one who works for Mr. Donnelly?
He did.
What do you mean he did?
Sean's fired him, but that's not your problem.
No, my problem is why he tried to kill Tony. What the whole story is.
As I said, he's a suspect. However, there is something else you should know about him.
What?
When we were all in Mexico together, it's quite possible he was staying at the Hacienda.
At my grandmother's?
I called her before I came here. She's flying up tomorrow.
Mariah's coming in here tomorrow.
Yes, she arrives at noon tomorrow.
Well, that's wonderful, but she doesn't know anything about Matt Hines.
No, but I'm hoping you do. Now, I want to reconstruct every move that you made the day of the incident at the hospital.
Robert, why would this guy have attacked Tony? Why?
We don't know that he did yet. First, I have to place him on the scene. And the big question there is, how did he get into the hospital in the first place?
Oh, well, that's easy.
You mean you know?
Yeah, I was there. We both were there.
Wait a minute. Back up a little. We were both there. We were where?
We were at the student union when everybody got sick. Matt got sick, too, and we went to the emergency at the hospital.
Felicia, are you absolutely certain that you saw Matt Hines in the emergency room at the hospital?
Of course I'm certain. We were at the student union. We all got sick together. You remember?
Well, I remember being there, but it was crazy. It was all the confusion. I don't know.
Well, I'm certain. I not only saw him, but he confirmed it the other day.
You mean you've spoken to him since?
It was at Sean's office. I said I was in the emergency room, and I turned around and looked for him, and he was gone.
What was his response to that?
He said he wasn't as sick as the others and that he didn't want to be treated, so he just left.
Okay. You said you've seen Hines in Donnelly's office. How often?
Several times. Why?
Because the more you've seen him, it means the more you're going to be able to recall. Now, at this point, what I want you to do is probably establish a log of every time, every recollection that you are ever together.
It's usually better if you put that kind of log down in writing.
A log? This is crazy. If you know the guy tried to kill my brother, why don't you arrest him? If he doesn't tell you anything, beat
Frisco.
The hell out of him.
Frisco, look. That's not the way it's done. see that in movies, perhaps, but not real life. Now, look, police work is about 90% dull, monotonous, boring routine, and a ton of paperwork to boot.
Paperwork, like the log you want us to write.
Exactly. Your best recollections of the both of you, singly, that you ever spent with the suspect.
I still don't see what good that is going to do.
Didn't you say that you wanted to help nail the person?
Of course, Rob. You know that.
And trust me, will you? This is the best way to help. Now you get a book or a piece of paper, whatever. And write everything down. When you've got it down, call me.
We'll do it together. Right away.
Frisco?
All right. Whatever you say.
Good. I'm going over to the dorm to check on Hines' alibi. Can I drop you, huh?
Yes, please. You know, you'll be surprised how much more you remember when you start writing it down.
And listen, include everything, no matter how small or insignificant the detail. Put it all down. I'll be waiting for your call.
We'll do our best.
Bye,
bye, darling.
All right. We got to do this. Let's do it. Let's get it over. You got something to write on? A pad of paper, a notebook or something?
No, but I have this, and I can copy it down in a notebook later. Where do you want to start?
Where I want to start and where Scorpio wants to start are two different places.
I know you want to start on Matt Hines in person.
That's exactly what I want to do. If we could find him.
Yes, but you'll land yourself right back in jail again. There's another method for school, and I think we should stick with it.
All right. Well, then we'll start where you want, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, he was your buddy.
It was nothing to me.
We have a funny way of showing that. Look, that doesn't matter. This is for Tony. Let's get on with it.
I thought you'd forgotten the purpose for a moment.
I didn't.
Okay. Well, where do we start?
Why don't we start with the night I caught you with this guy at Dino's?
You didn't catch me. I was there, that's all.
Don't worry, I know. I know what I saw. I don't know what I missed afterwards, though.
Just what are you insinuating?
Oh, I'm not insinuating anything. We're making a log, right? You gotta write things down. You slept with the guy, didn't you?
No.
Nothing happened?
Nothing. But thanks for caring.
Let's just write the log down, okay? Let's get with it.
Fine, but not here.
What?
Well, I think if we're going to do this right, we ought to return to the scene.
What do you mean, the scene? Where?
At Dino's. Where else? It has a nice atmosphere. Are you coming?
All right.
I'm going to go get my notebook.
Why do we have to go to Dino's? What's wrong with Kelly's? I mean...
What on earth was that sound?
What sound?
That sound you just made. It sounded like a dying gasp.
No, you got it all wrong. That was the sound of unbridled delight. You have a great pair of hands.
I know. That's why you married me.
Actually, there were two reasons.
Oh. What was the other one?
I'll tell you later. I needed that.
Well, tell me about Hines, that guy Hines.
Well, he didn't have an alibi the day that Tony Jones was attacked.
Oh?
Also, he lied to Felicia about going back to work after the emergency.
Sounds like this Mr. Hines is going to have an awful lot of explaining to do.
A whole lot. You know, I reckon if I can pin this on him, I can solve more than one puzzle. I mean, apart from Tony being attacked, we've also got Peter and maybe Van.
And before even that, you're smoothing out some rough edges, aren't you?
What?
I mean, you're sort of playing Cupid.
Moi?
Felicia and Frisco.
What about them?
Now, come on. Don't be ashamed just because you're the sentimental type. It's one of the reasons why I love you so much.
Well, I'm delighted, but what have I done?
Telling those two to write a log together, really.
I was serious.
Oh, I know. But if they accidentally get back together again whilst they're doing it,
Look, it's just an every ordinary day occurrence. Yeah.
Well, if they do get back together again, guess who's going to take all the credit for it?
Who?
You.
No?
Yeah.
Anchovies. Who ever heard of a pizza without anchovies?
I have. I hate anchovies.
Nevertheless, you should order one. It's very important.
What is the big deal about ordering a pizza with anchovies?
I want to recreate the mood.
The mood? Mm-hmm. What are you talking about?
Well, last time I was here with Matt, he ordered a large pizza.
Big deal.
With anchovies.
Well, by all means, let's recreate the mood then.
Thank you. Okay. Now you order and I'll find the exact table. Excuse me, I don't remember Dino's having music. Is that a new addition?
Yeah, they just installed it about 2 weeks ago. Isn't it great?
Yeah, it makes me feel like that.
Can we get going already?
Okay, but I got one more.
Come on! I mean, you're not a DJ. Felicia!
I'll get my notebook. What do you want me to enter first?
Oh, you met this jerk before I did, didn't you?
No, it was at Sean's office.
Well, then I think you should put that down.
Okay. I don't know how to do it. I mean, he came on to me.
Oh, well, how nice. You mean the same way he was coming on to you when I caught you two at Kelly's?
I remember that. He decked you with one punch. Should I put that in the log?
You put down the truth. The truth is that I was on to this guy. I knew he was no good from the very beginning. My intuition told me that, which is more than you can say.
Intuition?
Yeah.
No, you were just jealous.
Me jealous?
You're turning green.
Oh, come on, Felicia. Well, yeah, you just feel stupid because you let this idiot come on to you.
I didn't let him. He was fast.
Fast? Look, I don't want to argue about it, okay? Robert wants us to make a log, so let's do it.
Fine.
The sooner it's over, the better.
I agree.
Good. And just write it all down, lay it on the line, you and Hines.
And leave you out of the picture?
As I recall, I was out of the picture.
No, you were with a waitress and, the front girl, now that I think about it.
It's irrelevant.
Yes?
Look, you can't fill this whole thing up with immaterial baloney, okay? If you do that, we're going to be doing this forever.
I know.
Okay, so just keep all the emotional byplay out of it and just stick to this. It doesn't have anything to do with it.
Right.
Good.
But I think we should take our time with this. We want to be accurate.
Of course we want to be accurate. We're helping Scorpio. That's why we're doing this.
Okay.
Oh, I hate these things.
You know, Robert and Holly were right. It's amazing how much you remember when you just write things down.
Like what?
Well, like I remember two other times when I was with Matt Hines.
Here?
No, it was at the shipping office. And he had this weird way of looking at me.
I think this whole thing is weird. If Hines was really at the Hacienda in Texas, why would he come back to Port Charles and risk being caught? It doesn't make sense.
That's not our job.
What isn't our job?
To decide what makes sense. We're supposed to just write down what happened, the facts.
Well, that's what we've done, haven't we?
Well, I'm not sure. He said so much when we were here. I don't want to forget anything.
Well, like, what did he say?
Well, you know, the usual things.
No, I don't know. What usual things?
Well, I don't really remember.
Force yourself.
Actually, he said a lot of things when we were dancing.
You dance with that jerk?
Well, I didn't know he was a jerk when I danced with him.
Go on. What'd he say to you?
Well, I think it would be a lot easier if we could recreate the scene.
Like how?
Like you could dance with me. Look, you want to nail the guy who attacked your brother or not?
Well, you know that I do.
Well, then help me get back into the mood.
You think dancing is going to help create that mood?
Well, it should. I'll never know unless I try.
Well, what song were they playing when you guys danced? Well, so much for accuracy. I mean, how do you expect me to get back into it or you
well,
get back into it?
Once we get started, maybe I'll remember. That's really not the point. It's a matter of what Matt might have said. The more I remember, the more I'll remember.
Well, yeah.
Well?
Well, it's all in the line of duty, right? This is for Tony and Scorpio?
Right.
All right. Is this the area here?
Mm-hmm.
How was he holding you?
His hand was around me like this. This is normal dancing.
All right. So we were talking then, right?
Mm-hmm. I'm thinking. I was a little bit closer.